What it do you to today's video? I want to turn you with a quick impromptu video. In today's video, spiritual updates part two. So first things first, I want to say shout out to all my subscribers, shout out to my loyal subscribers who've been following me since day one, even on my main YouTube channel that I don't have access to anymore, King603Joey. Yes, it is the real King603Joey. Shout out to all my loyal subscribers who've been following my main backup channel since I first created it damn near almost 2 years ago. Shout out to y'all, you know what I'm saying? The restart, you know, the reset, you know, the journey, it hasn't been easy. And restarting it most definitely hasn't been easy, but it is what it is. We shall continue to fight satanic oppression. Now, before I start, you know, I must have to say shout out to Hana Meds. You know what I'm saying? They have them here in Phoenix, Arizona. I'm not sure if they're in any other states. They possibly might be. I'm not too sure, but I know for a fact they're here in Arizona. And what I was just smoking on is some Zaza, some gas, you know what I'm saying? By the brand Huxton. You see what I'm saying? This is Zen. Excuse me. It's Relax and Rejuvenate. You know what I'm saying? The name of the strain is called Fatso. Yes, Fatso. This is like 26%. This shit is some Zaza. That's what I was just smoking on. I had to put this shit out. That shit's some fire, though. You know what I'm saying? Some gas. You know, but shout out to them. But first, I want to say, seen Fat Joe and Kamala Harris talking about how they're trying to help people who've been arrested for petty marijuana crimes or just marijuana crimes in general. They're trying to get them released out of prison and get their record expunged because, you know, their life was ruined by just petty marijuana charge by, you know, laws and regulations that Joe Biden and Kamala Harris passed, you know, back in the day. And no, I'm not saying that, Kamala is evil and shit like that, that they actions can't be forgiven or they can't be changed, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, are you still alive? Are you breathing? You know, it's always a second chance. Every day you wake up, that's another chance at life. You know what I'm saying? You speak metaphorically. It's true, and it's good that they try to get people out, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, when those people get out, y'all need to be helping them with the social equity program, giving them people ownership of dispensaries and stuff so they could be making some type of revenue, because you gotta think about it, it's not fair. And you know what I'm saying? I'm a Rasta, you know what I'm saying? To the core, you know what I'm saying? I respect the culture, I respect the lifestyle. You see what I'm saying? Because cannabis is a lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? And it's a medicine. And it's just unfair for all these people, including myself, to be smoking the cannabis. And these same people who got arrested and their life ruined, they getting out of jail. And they seeing people smoking the same stuff and selling the same stuff and getting rich off the same stuff that ruined their life or got them thrown in jail. So I think they should have more benefits to that. But at the same time, it's a good start. So shout out to Kamala, shout out to Fat Joe for that. I give them that, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, man. But if you pay attention, though, look like Fat Joe hit that Kamala, no, he stopped playing. Like, he hit that from the back, no, he stopped playing, though. But, nah, Kamala, she not a bad looking woman. She actually a good looking woman, you see what I'm saying? Like, she's smart, like, that's good, you know what I'm saying? Fat Joe, he got the influence. You know, especially when it comes to the drug kind of shit, because that's what he, you know, most mostly rapped about, but that's where he came from, that type of lifestyle. So I give Fat Joe that, you know what I'm saying? I give him that. That's one step in the right direction. But, and I'm pretty sure it's probably still in the beginning phases of, you know, what they're trying to do, of pardoning those people. But like I said, when they get out, y'all need to be introduced into the social equity, to the Medicaid, as she was talking about, and all that type of stuff. Like, that's decent. It's deep. But at the same time, Hassan Campbell, right? Most of these motherfuckers are going to be too old to even do anything. But at the same time, it's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you still alive. Some motherfuckers don't even get out of jail at all. They die in prison. You see what I'm saying? Whether they old or whether they young. So you have to look at it like that, too. You know what I'm saying? You know? So that's actually some real shit. The P. Diddy shit is just more and more updates coming out. The official video of the raid that took place inside of his house. I think it was his house in L.A., I think. One of P. Diddy's sons, one of their moms, leaked the footage and showed how the raid was inside the house and stuff like that. And that's just crazy, though. But the thing is, it's just like, they talking about some P. Diddy was a confidential informant for the FBI this whole time. Man, I can believe that to an extent, because it's like they let him do all the shit that he thought he wanted to do, all the shit that he wanted to do, and oh yeah, we'll let it slide, you know what I'm saying? You work for us, and then, you know, P. Diddy, an arrogant bastard. So you already know he thinking about this, man, nigga, they need me. Nigga, they can't just take me down. This bad boy, nigga. They can't just take us down. They need me the whole time. They was just gathering evidence on you for these last 27 years because they knew you had something to do with the Tupac shit. And I'm going to be honest with you. I'm assuming after the Tupac murder, in the Biggie murder, because Biggie died 6 months after that. He died in 1997. Because you got to remember, Tupac died in September 13th. Was it September 13th? Yeah. Yeah, he died September 13th. He got shot in 1996, so. Yeah, so that makes sense because September is damn near at the end of the year, you know what I'm saying? September, October, November, December, January, February, March. That's 6 months after that Biggie died, March 1997. So I'm assuming that's when P. Diddy became a confidential informant. That's what I'm assuming. You see what I'm saying? After that situation, unless he already came in the game as a confidential informant, because you gotta remember one of his handlers in the beginning was Andre Harrell. And if you don't really know too much on him, Andre Harrell is the one who groomed one of the people. He had a few people like Clyde Davis and stuff like that, but I don't really know too much on the story between Clyde Davis and P. Diddy, but I know for a fact Andre Harrell, he was one of his handlers. But Andre Harrell was a big time drug trafficker back in the day from Harlem, and he was tied into the Sandinistas and the Contras controversy back in the day with Freeway Rick Ross and all that type of shit. When Ronald Reagan and them and the government allowed cocaine and all that shit to flood through America so they could help, basically raise the money to fund the war that was happening in South America and shit. That's basically what it was. So during that time, the CIA and shit was already involved with a lot of street cats, like Freeway Rick Ross. One of the niggas he was getting his shit from was an informant for the CIA. And Andre Harrell was tied up in that controversy. So obviously, the motherfucking feds and the CIA was already watching P. Diddy and them. So that's what I'm thinking. But I'm really thinking he became a confidential informant with the FBI after Tupac in the back. That's when he really got on his ass. Around that time, it could have been even before Tupac in the back, when they was beefing heavily and shit like that with the East Coast, West Coast shit. You know what I'm saying? Or even when Tupac got shot the first 5 times and shit, and he survived. I'm just saying, it's a paper trail for this shit, and they finally found it. But that shit's crazy, though. Wake the damn up. More videos coming soon. Fuck Satan. Fuck all this maids, man. You know how we rocking. Not this shit. But not real talk, though. More videos coming soon.